In the previous video, we created this website template, which is very common amongst many websites, where we have many items on the left, and then a main content area taking up the majority of the rest of the screen. Now, as you're building out your website, it's likely that you're going to want to change how some of the elements work to suit the specific needs or styles of your website, which is what we're going to cover during this video. So as you can see, I've taken away the code from our previous video where we had a video displayed, and I've replaced it with the code for a button. The button doesn't do anything at the moment, but it's what we're going to use to demonstrate the styling abilities of Polymer. So as you can see, the code is very simple. It's simply just importing the button element, using the button element with the text that we want to display inside of it. So the first thing to say about styling elements of Polymer is that many of the elements are already styled in multiple different ways, and it may be the case that the style that you're after is already completed. So if we head over to the elements website and select paper elements and then paper button, and then click demo on the left, we can see that all of these elements are already stylized and already included by default. So if we wanted to make our element raised, for example, we can do that very easily. And if we look at the document, it actually tells us how to do this, which is simply to add the raised flag to our element. So if we do that, and go back to the website, and refresh, we can see that we have a border added to the button, which obviously doesn't change anything else other than the fact that the border is added. Despite being Polymer elements, these elements can also be stylized as though they were normal HTML elements. So I've gone ahead and added a style tag here, although you would normally create a style sheet. And in this case, we're just going to stylize our main button. And we're just going to add a margin of 16 pixels. If we refresh the page, this is obviously going to be applied as we would expect it to be with any other element. Now, something which is commonly saw within buttons in particular is icons. And in this case, we're talking about saving something, so we can add a save icon into this as well. So I've just gone ahead and imported two libraries, one specifically called ironicon and one called ironicons. I've then added this tag, which is an icon tag in itself, but it uses an icon property to specify that it's going to display an icon called save, which is one of the icons which is included with Polymer. And by refreshing the page, we can see that we have this icon automatically included for us. A practice that other libraries used to follow was to include several PNG files, with each PNG file being a different colour of the icon that we wanted to use. Polymer, however, takes advantage of modern practices and actually colours the colour of icons in the same colour as the text within the button itself. So if we used our style to go ahead and change the colour of the text, in this case just to red, when we refresh the page, everything's going to refresh and be in the same colour as we would expect it to be. This dramatically simplifies the entire process of including different icons, because you no longer have to worry about which PNG file you need to include. Polymer takes care of that for you. Another strength of Polymer's is the fact that it is exploring how to include themes in your website. The functionality at present is very experimental, and so I'm not going to go into very much detail about it. But if you were to explore your Bower components file and explore, for example, the paper button element, if you open the element up and scroll down, you will see the current style, which is shipped by default with the element. You will, however, also notice things like apply and paper button. And this is because Polymer is actually exploring the possibility of using native CSS mixins, which will allow you to create entire themes from a single file, with the idea being that if you apply a mixin to an element, all of the current properties which ship by default with the elements will be applied first, but then your mixing properties will be applied, so you can therefore override the previous properties. If we were to open the iron icon element and explore this, we can see that some of the elements are being used in a slightly different way. So for example, we're specifying the iron icon height and the iron icon width, and these are being treated as individual variables as opposed to entire mixins. As I say, I'm not going to go into a whole lot of detail about how to apply themes at the moment because the entire functionality is very experimental, but further information is available on the Polymer project website under local DOM and then styling. So we have the cross scope styling section here, which talks about how to use the mixins and how the old methods which we're using deep and shadow are not entirely the best ways to do things. And it also introduces the idea of custom CSS properties and how to use them, as well as a help guide on the Mozilla website to how to actually go about using them properly. If you are interested in creating a theme of your own, I would recommend going to a website such as polymerthemes.com, which provides sample templates which you can use as a starting point for your own theme. It's simply a matter of downloading the theme and importing that into your Polymer project. If you were to open up the downloaded style sheet, you'd see that a vast majority of the initial settings are basically just normal CSS settings. But as you progress, you will see more and more of these custom CSS properties being used. In the next video, we're going to talk about the practicalities of using custom elements for your website. Most specifically about how to use data binding to actually use data with your elements in a consistent way. So make sure you're subscribed so you don't miss that.